Dear First Prep, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It's Mr. Ahmed Mahmoud with you today to introduce a new mathematics lesson. Today, inshallah, we have the first lesson in the geometry this term. Unit 3, lesson 1. The lesson is called the deductive proof. In this lesson, inshallah, we are going to study how can we write the steps in the geometry problems by using the deductive proof. Let's start the lesson. Okay, first we need to remember that what we studied in the first term. Okay, the first rule with us, the sum of measures of the interior angles of the triangle is 180. For example, if we have a triangle like this, this triangle formed from three angles, so the sum of their measures equal 180. This is the first theorem with us. Okay, now we have a very important remark. When we write the steps of the proof, we use this symbol. This symbol, okay, two dots up and dot down. This symbol is called since. Again, this symbol is called since. Okay, we use since to write what? We use this symbol to write a given or a rule. Again, we use this symbol to write a given or a rule like this. So, if we need to write a given or a rule, so we use this symbol since. Okay, and we have another symbol. This symbol, two dots down and dot up. This symbol is called therefore. Again, this symbol is called therefore. Okay, we use therefore to write a conclusion or a result. Again, we use this symbol to write a conclusion or a result. Okay, now let's study the first example with us by using the deductive proof. Okay, in this question, in the opposite figure, as we see, first we need to read the given carefully. Okay, in the opposite figure, AD intersect BC at E, like as we see here, the two lines intersect at the point E. Okay, and AE equal DE, as we see, EE equal DE, and BE equal CE, BE equal CE, as we see. Okay, prove that the two triangles are congruent. Again, prove that two triangles are congruent. Okay, first we start to write three objects. The first object is called given. Okay, what is the given? The given, okay, that the components that he gave you in the problem. So I'm going to write the first given, that AD intersect BC at E. The second given, AE equal DE. The third given, BE equal CE. So I'm going to write the given, as I said before, AD intersect BC at E, AE equal DE, BE equal CE. Okay, the second object is called RTP. What is RTP? RTP required to be proved. Again, RTP, abbreviation of required to be proved. Okay, what is the required here? The required here, he asked me to prove that AEC congruent to triangle DAB. This is the required. So I'm going to write, prove that triangle AEC congruent to triangle DEB, okay, as we see, this is the required. The third object is called the proof. The proof is the solution steps. Okay, now the proof. The first step in the proof, we have here AD and BC intersect at one point. So I conclude that we have two equal angles, which is called VOA. Again, AD and BC are two intersecting lines. So I conclude two equal angles, the two angles called VOA. So the first step, since AD intersect BC at E, so, or therefore, okay, measure angle AEC equal to measure of angle DEB, as I said, VOA. Okay, now by looking to the two triangles AEB, AEC and BED, okay, we see what in the two triangles AEC and DEB, we see what? I conclude three, I need three, okay, givens. What are the three givens? The first given, that AE equal DE. This is number one. BE equal EC. This is number two. Measure angle AEC equal to measure of angle BED. This is number three. The three givens, okay, we give me that the two triangles are congruent. So number one, AE equal to DE, number two. CE equal to BE, number three. Measure angle AEC equal measure of angle DEB. From one and two and three, we get that the two triangles are congruent as we see. Let's study another example. Okay, in this example, as we see, first we are going to read the given carefully. In the opposite figure, BAC equal 80 degrees as we see there. Okay, measure angle DCE equals 120 degrees and the measure of angle ACE equals 140. Prove that this is the required, that AB parallel to CD. Now I need to prove that AB parallel to CD. As we studied before in the first term, to prove that two lines are parallel, we need one of the three cases. We need to prove that there is two alternate angles and equal in measure, or two corresponding angles and equal in measure, or two interior angles and supplementary. Okay, I see how now U-shape. Again, I see now U-shape. The U-shape, this is the interior angles. So I need to prove that the two angles, C and A, their sum equal 180 degrees. Okay, first I'm going to write the given. The given here, BAC equal 80, DCE equal 120, ACE equals 140 degrees. As I said, okay, like this. The required to prove that AB parallel to CD. Okay, this is the required, the proof. The first step, okay. Now I have three angles around, I need to find the angle C. Okay, now I have angles around the point C. The sum of their measures equal what? These angles called accumulative angles. Then the sum of their measures equal 360 degrees. So this angle equal 360 minus 120 plus 140 equal 100 degrees. Okay, so since DCA, I said since because this is a given, or so this is a rule. Okay, since DCA and DCE and ACB, here I mean the angles around C equal what? It's equal 360. Therefore, measure of angle ACD equal 360 minus 120 plus 140, which is equal 100 degrees. Okay, now by adding 80 plus 100 degrees, I get what? I get now BAC plus DCA equal 100 plus 80, or 80 plus 100 equal 180, and they are interior angles, therefore AB parallel to CD, and this is the required to be proved. Okay, and this is the end of the lesson. I hope it was helpful for you. See you inshallah in the next video. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh.